Well, folks, there is our introduction to Take 5 for you. It is a Monday night, and we are on day 17 of our adventure to move you forward into making a difference in your life and adding value to those around you. You know, when I look at that idea of adding value, when Jesus told the disciples, the original disciples, to go and make disciples of the nation, that was something that was going to add value to the life of individuals and to the lives of nations. That's what we're still called to do today. We're not called to be average. We're not called to be lukewarm. In fact, read Revelation, and you'll see in the Laodicean church, he said, I have this against you. You're not hot and you're not cold. That means you're lukewarm. We saw a great movie the other night, my wife and I. It's really a great movie. You need to go and see War Room. War Room. And I'll just put it this way. One of the ladies in the film was talking to another lady, and she was talking about, well, how is your spiritual condition? And she said, well, I guess it's okay. I guess it's okay. You know, I'm probably just about like everybody else. And so the host lady, she said, well, would you like a cup of coffee? I'm going to make myself a cup of coffee. And she said, oh, yeah, that would be great. So she brought her a cup of coffee, two cups of coffee, one for each person. And the hostess was drinking her coffee, and it was nice and hot. And the lady who was the visitor, who said, well, I'm just like everybody else, she took one sip of her coffee. It was not hot, and it was not cold. It was lukewarm, and she got really kind of a grimace look on her face and said, oh, my. And the lady was bringing out a very good observation and just a very practical lesson in what it's like to be lukewarm and how nobody likes lukewarm. I mean, I like iced tea. I don't drink coffee. My wife drinks coffee. Now, she drinks hot coffee and she drinks iced coffee. In other words, cold. But she does not like lukewarm coffee. And I'm the same way with my tea. I like iced tea and I like hot tea. Lukewarm tea, I'll put up with it for a little bit, but it's not what I want. It's not what I want. I want it hot or I want it cold. Well, we're going to move on today. We're going to move you forward into getting out of perhaps this idea that being just average, just getting by is okay. You know, when you went to school, you had the opportunity, you know, of being whatever student that you wanted to be, depending on how much you were willing to work. The more you worked, the more you studied, the more you put an effort into it, the higher your grades were going to be. The less you did, well, you just took your chances. But you know, today we're going to highlight the idea of we're not going to be average. In fact, average is an enemy. It's an enemy that will not move you any place except backwards. I would like to just take this. Never try to defend your position and situation. Choose to be a person who is on the offensive, not the defensive. When you're on the offensive, you're hot. Particularly in sports. I mean, I understand this from being an athlete in my younger years. When we were moving down the field, we were hot. And I mean, that's a term that can be used. You know, you are hot. I mean, you're making baskets. You're making catches. You're making throws. You're making tackles. It doesn't matter what it is. If you're moving forward, you're hot. You're more than average. But people who will live defensively, in other words, just backing up or just trying to maintain. Well, I'm just trying to maintain. I'm just trying to lay back and be cool. You're never going to rise above average. And if you never rise above average, there's only one place you can go, and that's backwards. Backwards. Okay? We're not called to be indecisive people. But you know, when you look at a person who is lukewarm, by and large, they are indecisive. And it doesn't matter whether they're wealthy, educated, or hold high positions. There is a lot of people in each one of those categories that basically you could say that they're lukewarm. They just maintain. And that's all they want to do. They want to maintain their position. They want to maintain their wealth. They want to maintain whatever education they got, but they're not going anyplace else. They're just maintaining. So in essence, they're average. It's average. Now, let's take a look at some scripture. And as we take a look at some scripture, make this proclamation right now. I will not be average. I will move forward. I will move forward. And if there is an obstacle in my way, I am going to find a way to go through it, around it, over it, or under it. With the help of God and whoever else He brings into my life to help me. Remember we spoke about the other day that Jesus wants to make that yoke light? Ask Jesus to get next to you and you together pick up that yoke and you go through it. You go through it. We're going to look at spiritual growth in Colossians chapter 1 and starting at verse 9. We read this as Paul has written this letter to the Colossian church, and he says, "For this reason also, the day we heard this, we haven't stopped praying for you. We are asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, so that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him, bearing fruit in every good work, and growing in the knowledge of God." That's Colossians 1, verses 9 and 10. There is a lot on there in just those two verses that if you will acknowledge those verses as being yours and begin to declare, I'm going to read this declaration and I hope you will follow through, listen to it, write it in your journal, and make it yours. I can't overemphasize, make the Bible and your relationship with God yours. Make it personal. I think I've shared in the past, I have a New Testament, Psalms and Proverbs that has my name in it. It was a special edition that was given to me as a gift, and you can buy them. But it says this in verse 9, and I'm going to go through this quickly, but I want you to gain this idea that when you start declaring and seeking after God's knowledge, God's wisdom, and spiritual understanding, you will not be lukewarm. You will be hot. You cannot do this even cold. And it will move you out of being in that position of being just average. Satan is really happy with average Christians, because most average Christians are also those lukewarm Christians. And Satan knows. He knows the word of God. And he says, I will spew you out of my mouth according to that word, is what Jesus said. Jesus doesn't want lukewarm and average. He wants hot. And if you can't be hot, at least be cold and be just frozen where you're at and steady and immovable, because you're like a frozen object. You're like, I'll put it this way. You are like, what is it called? An iceberg. An iceberg is a big frozen solid object. And it's usually got greater depth beneath it than what you see on top. Well, make that depth beneath it that people can't see, even though you are frozen, the depth that you hold is in the wisdom and knowledge of God. Now, let's look at this. Break it down a little bit more. I'm going to put it this way. I am asking, and this is my prayer for you. For this reason also, since the day I heard of you, and I don't know all of you that are listening, but I'm speaking directly to you. For this reason, since the day that I have heard of you, I haven't stopped praying for you or sharing with you. I am asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding for your life, so that you may walk worthy of the Lord. I say, be fully pleasing to Him in all things that you do, bearing fruit in every good work and growing in the knowledge of God on a daily basis. This is my prayer for you. And I hope that you will take the time to move to the next level. To move to the next level. And it is my desire. It is my desire to help you to move up to the next level in your wisdom, in your spiritual understanding, in your knowledge, and in your desire to be hot. So let's move forward. Together, God has some great plans for you and for me. So we can stand our watch where God would have us to look over His kingdom and to see that we are in such a place with spiritual understanding and wisdom and a desire in our heart to see the kingdom of God expanded wherever we are.
I will stand my watch, and I will guard my gate.